fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty high-o silver, the Lone Ranger.
This is a story of one of the most mysterious characters to appear in the early days of the West. He was a fabulous individual. A man whose presence brought fear to the lawless and hope to those who wanted to make this frontier land their home. He was known as the Lone Ranger. For weeks now, the Lone Ranger and his faithful Indian companion, Tonto, have been pursuing the vicious Pete Madden gang. Wanted for cattle rustling by every sheriff west of the Mississippi, these desperate outlaws have left a trail of robbery, destruction, and murder. At long last, their leader, Pete Madden himself, has finally been captured by the angry ranchers. But at what a heavy cost. For the Madden gang has already struck back ruthlessly by abducting young Jim Patrick, son of one of the ranchers, to hold as a hostage for their vicious leader. Every rancher in the country is up in arms. Every rancher, that is, but two newcomers to this part of the West, Fred Vance and his wife, Mary.
We can't stop here, Mary. We're not far enough away from the last place.
Oh, Fred, it's such beautiful country. And look, there's a perfect spot to build our new home. We could risk it. We've got to stop running away sometime. Please.
Well, it is beautiful country, and I heard that the land was for sale. But you know what it means if the neighbors find out who I am.
Well, we could always change our name.
No, Mary. I'm proud of my name. I've done nothing to make us ashamed of it. It stays the same, no matter where we settle, no matter what the consequences. Now, do you still want to build here, or do we move on?
I want to build here, Fred.
All right, Mrs. Vance. Where we set up housekeeping. We start right now.
Oh, our new home site. I'm going to love it here, Fred.
We found the Madden gang's hideout at last.
Me not understand, Kimusabi. All tracks of Madden gang lead out of hideout, not into it.
That can mean only one thing. Madden and his gang are out on another raid. Most likely in the next county where Tom Patrick and his ranchers are so stirred up against him.
We follow tracks, Kimusabi?
I don't think we'll have to, Tonto. This hideout is Madden's stronghold. Whatever he's up to, he's almost sure to return here. I'll keep watching those rocks up yonder. You scout around. Make sure those tracks do lead toward the next county. I'll meet you at our camp in the morning.
Maybe waiting, Kimusabi.
You must be done in, Fred. Never saw you work so hard. Why don't you take a rest?
Got no time for rest. I'm building more than a home. I'm building a fort. This time, nobody will drive us away.
Who'd drive us away from here, Fred? No one knows it.
Nobody knew it was the last fort place that we tried to settle either. Look, Mary, we bought this land fair and honest. Used up almost all of our money to do it. Got just enough to buy a few cows and register a brand. We're here for keeps. And I'll fight anybody who says different.
Before you fight them, Fred, let's try to be friends with them, shall we?
We'll see.
Howdy, neighbor. Howdy, ma'am. My name's Patrick, Tom Patrick.
We're glad you came a-calling, Mr. Patrick.
I'm afraid this isn't a social call, ma'am.
No? What's on your mind, Patrick?
You look as though you'd be right handy, toting a gun.
I can use one when I have to.
Did you ever hear of the Madden gang?
Madden gang? Well, they used to operate in the county where I had a ranch before. Gave us plenty of trouble.
I reckon you won't mind coming along, then. And helping the rest of us ranchers track them down. We've got Madden in jail, but his gang is holding my boy Jim as hostage.
Mister, it'd be a pleasure to ride after those hombres.
We're meeting at my place in town in 3 hours. See, I don't think I got your name.
Vance. Fred Vance. And this is...
Vance!
That's right.
Why, you're nothing but a dirty outlaw yourself. You spent a year in jail for rustling.
That's a lie. I'm no rustler.
The law says different. I got a list of every rustler let out of jail in the past year, and your name's right at the top.
He was innocent, Mr. Patrick. It was Madden's men who pulled that raid.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I got no proof of that. And if you don't want us to round you up with the rest of the Madden gang, you better get off of this land pronto.
Let him try to run us off. Just let him try.
Trail till dark, Kemosabe. See no sign of Madden gang. Come back here to camp.
I had better luck than you, Tonto.
You mean you find out something last night?
Yes. All we need to know.
Them come back to hideout?
Right after midnight. I couldn't see much because it was so dark, but I heard plenty.
Them off on another raid?
Yes, only this time it didn't come off so well. Tom Patrick and his ranchers managed to capture Madden. That leaves the gang without their leader.
That's plenty good news.
There's some bad news, too. The gang is holding Tom Patrick's son, Jim, as hostage. I would have tried to rescue him, but it was too dark.
You and me go back, get him now?
No, Tonto. The boy's safe enough for a while. But if his father and those ranchers come after him in a body, they'll ride into an ambush.
You think it better we ride to town first, see Tom Patrick?
If we don't, a lot more lives may be endangered. Tom's a brave man. Sometimes a little foolhardy. We'd better hurry, Tonto. There's no time to lose.
And I found this stuck in the door an hour ago. If Madden isn't free by noon Wednesday, your kid will die. Well, now we know their next move.
What are you going to do, Tom? The posse's raring to go as soon as you give the word.
If we only knew where their hideout was. It's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Those outlaws play for keeps. If we don't let Madden go, they'll kill Jim for sure.
You'll have to find their hideout before they can kill him.
You mean we're not letting Madden go? You'd risk Jim's life?
Don't get me wrong, Joe. I love my kid. But there's something more than just his life at stake. Madden is the brains of his gang. If we let him loose to lead them again, hundreds of innocent people will die. Now, we've got to find his gang without releasing him.
I think I can help you, friends. You don't need guns. I'm on your side.
Who are you and what do you want here?
The same thing you do. The Madden gang.
The lawman, eh? Then why the mask?
Have you ever seen one of these before?
Silver bullet. But there's only one man who wears a mask and fires a silver bullet, and he's...
Then you know me, Tom.
I sure do, stranger. And I've heard a lot of good things about you, too.
Tonto and I have been riding hard to get here. I've got news about the Madden gang. You see, we've been on their trail for quite a while.
Yes?
We've located the gang and your son in a hideout, about 2 days' ride from here.
Your son prisoner, near Redstone Pass.
Redstone Pass? I know that area. You heard that, boys? Let's get going.
Wait, Tom. A large posse wouldn't have a chance of taking them by surprise there.
Him right. Maybe 2-3 men, but not big group.
Tom, you'd better forget your men. Let me handle this.
I'm sorry, friend, but this is our fight. And it stands to reason that 10 men would have a better chance against them than just one or two. Let's go, boys.
Well, what about that cattle rustling Fred Vance? Do we go after him, too?
You bet we do. Soon as we take care of the Madden gang.
What do we do now, Kemosabe?
We've got to find a way of stopping those ranchers from riding into a massacre.
Many of them. Only two of us. Not enough.
Fred Vance. I read about his trial. He was convicted on mighty slim evidence. Tonto, we'll give Fred Vance a chance to prove he's not a cattle rustler. Come on.
Food's ready. You must be starved. Fred, no.
It's just a precaution, Mary. Maybe they won't even come. But if they do... Two of them. Well, I'm ready for them this time. Get behind the wagon.
Fire! We're friends!
I haven't got any friends!
Honey, he's masked. And that Indian.
They're not ranchers. They're part of Madden's gang.
We want to talk to you.
Don't come any closer, or this time I won't shoot over your heads.
He means it, Tonto. We'll use the possum trick.
Me savvy.
We're here to help you, Vance. We're coming in whether you like it or not.
Fred, you've killed them.
I warned him to stay back.
Sorry I had to do that, Fred.
All right, you got me. Go ahead. What are you waiting for?
Oh, Fred.
I told you. We're your friends.
Friends don't wear masks.
Sometimes they do. Release them, Tonto. And put away your gun. I'll explain.
Look here, I don't get this.
I've got a plan for rescuing Tom Patrick's boy before the Madden gang can ambush the ranchers who are now heading toward their hideout. But I'll need your help.
With every ranch in the country looking for my hide? Why should I help?
Because I believe you're an honest man. And one way to prove it is by going after those rustlers like any honest man would. Well, what do you say? Any sign of Tom Patrick and his ranchers yet, Tonto?
Not yet, Kimosabe.
You know, I reckon Patrick's not going to like the surprise one bit. He'll hate me even worse than he did after our run-in the other day.
He'll stop hating you soon enough, Fred, if you can deliver his son back to him.
You talk as if it was going to be easy. I've seen this Madden gang in action. I wouldn't be surprised if we were all taken prisoners. They're tough hombres.
We can be tough too, Fred. When we have to be.
Kimosabe, me here horses.
Good. Now do just as I told you.
Hands off those guns.
Out of the saddle, all of you. Tonto, get their guns.
I thought you were on our side. I might have known you'd be in cahoots with the rustlers.
He's no rustler, Tom, or he wouldn't be helping me save your son. We've been trailing you for 2 days. Now we'll take over. Got their guns, Tonto?
Huh.
Keep them covered till we get back. Sorry to have to do this, Tom. But I figure my way is safer than yours.
What can two men do alone? Ride into Madden's hideout like they had an invite?
Maybe. Come on, Fred. Let's go. Fred, we'll take Scott along for Jim.
Good.
We got a long wait. Better sit down.
This is where we separate, Fred. Madden's camp is over there. You understand now what you're to do.
I understand, all right, but supposing something goes wrong?
We'll worry about that if it happens. Your job is to free Jim Patrick. I'll try to take care of the rest of the gang. Good luck, Fred.
Thanks.
Talk to the Patrick kid.
All right, masked man, that's far enough. Put up your hands.
What kind of a welcome is that? I've ridden a long way to find the Madden gang.
Nobody finds the Madden gang till they prove they're not on the side of the law.
I was working for the law. You think I'd come in here myself to capture the whole gang single-handed?
Well, I reckon that makes good sense. All right, stranger, you can ride in and talk it over with the boss.
Yeah.
But don't forget, I've got you covered all the way.
Just about noon, Patrick. Looks like your old man don't value your hide too much. Were he to turn Madden loose, and he'd be here by now.
I hope he never lets him loose.
Hey, Nolan! Somebody's coming.
I'll see who it is. You stay here, Sam. Keep your hands up, stranger. But you know you're trespassing on private property.
Isn't that what the Madden gang specializes in? Trespassing on other people's property?
Just what do you mean by that, mister?
Well, what's good for the Madden gang? It's good enough for me.
Oh, that's why you're wearing the mask. Thinking about joining up with us, eh?
I've been trying to catch up with you for a long time.
Well, climb down, but don't try anything funny.
Sure.
It's a mighty fine horse you got there. You wouldn't want to tell me where you got him, would you?
No more than you'd want to tell me where you got yours.
You're all right, stranger. Come on over by the fire.
Thanks. Howdy.
Sit down. Take on some grub.
I wonder if that is Madden. Because if it ain't, you better start saying your prayers, Patrick. You just got a couple minutes left.
You haven't got much time left either. Someday they'll catch up with you polecats.
Polecats, huh? I'll show you who the polecats.
Not here. Rocky, take care of the Patrick kid.
Sure thing, Jake. Wished you'd have plugged in long ago.
Looks like we'll have to go after Madden ourselves. Are you with us, stranger?
Sure. I'd like nothing better than going after Pete Madden. Mind if I look at my horse first?
No, go ahead.
Hey, boss!
Yeah?
Somebody plugged Sam and got the boy away.
That may be your son, Jim. Take gun now. Go after Madden gang. Your horse is fresh. There's tired.
Thank you.
Jim. I was afraid I'd never see you alive again.
You wouldn't have, Dad. If it had been for the masked man and Fred Vance.
Fred, look.
You won't need that, Fred. We're proud to have you as a neighbor.
And if you'd let us, we'd like to help you finish your cabin.
Come on, boys, let's get to work.
Let's go.
There you are. Yes,
sir. We're glad to help.
We have work to do elsewhere, Tonto.
Gee, Mary, it looks like we're going to have a home at last. And friends, like the Patricks here. And Tonto and the Lone Ranger.
Hello, Silver! Hello!
With the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty high-o silver. The Lone Ranger.
This is a story of one of the most mysterious characters to appear in the early days of the West. He was a fabulous individual. A man whose presence brought fear to the lawless and hope to those who wanted to make this frontier land their home. He was known as the Lone Ranger. When the pioneers settled in the West, bringing civilization and the roots of progress to the barren plains, the Indian chiefs sent their braves out on the warpath to burn the settlements and kill those who pushed the wagon trains forward. Until the great white father in Washington sent his soldiers to make peace with the Indians. The most warlike of the chiefs was Lame Bear. Finally, even he had smoked the pipe of peace with the army. The white men were ordered to keep out of Lame Bear's territory. Here is the war horse Black Cloud. Fiery veteran of 100 campaigns, the most famous horse between our coasts.
Black Cloud, Chief Lame Bear's war horse. After the battle Lame Bear put up against the army, he's just about the most publicized horse in the country. What an act I could build around that animal. But do you think you can buy him for me, Madrigo?
Money will buy anything, Barlam. Especially that kind of money.
5,000. That's for Lame Bear. And another 5 for you when you deliver Black Cloud to me in St. Louis.
It's a deal.
Good.
Come on, Shorty, we're going to be busy.
Good luck, Madrigo.
I make my own luck, Barlam. $10,000. Pretty good pay for delivering a horse, eh?
Yeah, but 5,000 of it's for Lame Bear.
Yeah? More ways of getting a horse than paying for it. You ought to know that.
White hunters, Tonto. If they're after buffalo, they're heading for trouble. You know, this territory is reserved to Chief Lame Bear, and Lame Bear won't stand for trespassers. Come on, Tonto. We'd better warn them.
What's the matter?
We've got visitors.
Oh, one's a redskin and the other's masked. Now, what in the blazes?
Take it easy. This is no holdup, or they wouldn't show themselves. Maybe they want some grub. Remember to keep your mouth shut about what we're after. If word gets to Lame Beard that we're after Black Cloud, we're going to be out of luck.
Don't worry, Matt. We don't talk.
Howdy.
Hello. Hide hunters, eh?
That's right. Hide hunters. What's up? Need some grub? What's the mask for?
The mask is my business, and we're not after food. You're Matt Madrigo, aren't you?
That's right. How'd you know?
Aren't many hide hunters left. Recognize you from your description. Tonto and I want to warn you that you're trespassing on territory reserved to Chief Lame Bear. You entered it when you crossed the green. If you know it's healthy, you'll turn back.
Maybe we don't care about our health. And if we don't, who's going to spoil it for us?
Lame Bear will. He'll try to anyhow. And maybe the Army. The Army wants to keep peace in this section.
All right, you've warned us. Thanks.
I take it you're not turning back, then.
What do you think?
I think you're looking for trouble.
That's our right, isn't it?
You'll find it. Montanu, these gentlemen are looking for trouble. We're wasting their time. And you may be wasting your scalps.
I sure put a burr in his tail. All right, Beggs, whip up the horses. Like the masked man said, we're wasting time.
You'd better ride to the Fort Tonto. Ask Colonel Graves for a detachment to turn them back.
Me do. If them after Buffalo, Lame Bear get plenty mad.
Yes, and start on the warpath. He's only looking for an excuse to fight these days. You go to the fort. I'll ride to Lazotte's trading post and see that Lame Bear learns about this in the right way. Get going, Tonto. I'll pick up your trail later.
Me go now.
Chief Lame Bear's son and a trusted brave made camp. The boy was pleased with the truce between his father and the white men. He went about his work tending the fire, unaware of the danger that lurked near, very near.
Come on.
Then suddenly his companion had a feeling that they were being watched. But he saw no one.
You and Tom go after Black Cloud. Sam and I will take care of the Redskins. Beggs, you follow me. We'll make a circle and come in behind them.
One redskin so good, he's plumb wholesome.
Forget this one over your saddle. I'll go back and see how the boy's made out with the horse.
You want this one for?
He may come in handy for a hostage if we need him. He's Chief Lame Bear's son. Black Cloud tied up?
Yeah, he sure put up a fight. It's quite a job.
And the Indians?
Sam just tied him and threw him in the wagon.
Good. Now, our job is to get back to the railroad as soon as we can. Let's get going.
Hey, give me the lift.
The wounded Indian boy struggles to reach his horse to report to Chief Lame Bear, with a message that will touch off the fires of war. Nestled among barren mountains in Indian territory, is the Burnt Hills trading post to which the Lone Ranger has ridden to talk to Chief Lame Bear.
Man with mask, speak with straight tongue. Lame Bear, do nothing now.
I don't know how you got him to promise to let the army handle Madrigo high, but you did.
It's trouble.
Madrigo made off with Lambert's son and his war horse. Lambert's raging. We got to get out of here.
You're right, Lazard. You get to your horse. I'll cover you in case of trouble. Run them, Lazard.
They'll go back to their village. And what you want to bet, in another hour, they're on their warpath.
Yes, and ready to kill every white man who gets in the way. We'll have to warn the army.
Quickest way to the fort is through that saddle.
But the quickest way to the army is to follow on Madrigo's trail. Tano is to get a detachment of soldiers who turn them back. We'll head off this way. On Silver.
I'm Lieutenant Bannister. You're trespassing on territory reserved to Lame Bear's tribe. I've come to order you back.
You're a little late, aren't you, Lieutenant? I've already turned back. Turned back when him and that masked partner of his told us to. First I knew we'd been trespassing.
You're a hide hunter, aren't you?
That's right.
What have you got in that wagon?
Take a look for yourself.
Men doing over there?
Take a look for yourself. One of our horses is bogged down.
Indian, you're wasting my time.
Lambert's war horse.
What do you want to do with him, boss?
Take him and get White Eagle out of the brush. Throw them both in the wagon. And get Black Cloud and time on behind.
We hadn't seen them soldiers coming when we did. We'd have been prisoners by now, and they'd have been taking us back to the fort. You're lucky, Matt.
Uh-huh. I told you I make my own luck. I don't like it, Lazard. This is where Madrigo camped. The cavalry were here and left without taking him into custody. His trail goes on. The cavalry went back. He's fooled them some way.
We'll have to hide to the fort, after all.
No, I'm going after Madrigo. You go to the fort. Yes.
Lame Bear will come through these hills, Colonel Graves. If we station our regiment right about here...
No, I won't do that. A show of force won't settle this. You see, according to Lazotte's story, Lame Bear is in the right. I'm going to talk to him.
Talk to him?
Yes, under the protection of the white flag. A parley. I know Lame Bear. He's been my friend. And a talk might do what fighting never will do. You'll come with me, Bannister. You too, Lazotte, if you feel up to it.
All right, Colonel. I can risk it if you can.
Lame Bear's in there. I can tell the signs. Took to cover when they saw us coming.
Lame Bear afraid of three men? It's a trap, sir.
Maybe. Well, shall we go on?
We're fools, sir. We ought to get out of here. We're not back.
Nonsense. Pull yourself together. We're only... I can do for you, Lazotte.
I sure could use a drink of water if you had.
Where's Biggs?
He's back there guarding the pass.
Figures he's going to die.
Well, he figures right.
Hey, that's no death chant. I savvy that lingo. He's signaling somebody.
No more of that engine. Reach. Pull out your gun and shoot at the sky. Now.
I beg. Get up there, all of you, and see what's up. Maybe a trick.
Friend, glad you dropped by. Moving. The hands behind. Not a very good tie, but it'll do till the boys get here. One more turn to make sure. There, that will hold you. Good. Boys are coming back.
Tonto, the knife.
Get behind the wagon.
You probably want to sleep.
I want to sleep.
Hey, Matt.
Raise your hands. I'll drop your guns. You. Get over there. Shot.
I'm out too.
I saw our horses yonder in a gully. Maybe we can make it to them.
Carrying him?
Of course. We haven't got a chance.
That's right. But I'd rather be out in the open when we haven't a chance. So let's try it. Give me a hand with it.
There's your father. Get to him, quick.
We were told you were headed this way. We came as soon as we could.
And just in time.
Here, I want to show you something. Grjngo and company. You've met these fellows before.
Yes, I have, and I'm glad to meet them again.
I thought you would be, Lieutenant. Colonel, you should be out of trouble once White Eagle has talked to his father. In fact, I think you're out of trouble right now.
Thank you, friend. We owe you our lives. I want you to understand that, Lame Bear. If you behave yourself, no more trouble from Washington. But if you don't, I'll make plenty of trouble. You savvy that?
Lame Bear, savvy.
Here's the man who should get the credit for this, my friend.
He fine fella. Big warrior. What him name?
No one knows. I can only tell you that most people call him the Lone Ranger.
With a speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty hi-yo silver. The Lone Ranger.
This is a story of one of the most mysterious characters to appear in the early days of the West. He was a fabulous individual. A man whose presence brought fear to the lawless and hope to those who wanted to make this frontier land their home. He was known as the Lone Ranger. The Lone Ranger and Tonto, in their ever-vigilant pursuit of outlaws and evildoers, have been riding for days to reach this ranch belonging to the lovely young Ellen Carter. They have learned that Ellen, who trusts no strangers, has been fighting desperately but futilely to save her property from the land-hungry hands of unscrupulous, violent men.
If you're more of Jeff Grant's hoodlums, come to frighten me off my ranch, you'll find I don't frighten easily.
We don't like Jeff Grant any better than you do, Miss Carter.
But if you're not one of Grant's men, why are you wearing that mask?
I wore the same mask when I helped your father clean up the old Potter gang. He may have told you about me. You ever seen one of these before?
A silver bullet. Then you must be the Lone Ranger.
Now will you trust Tonto and me to help you?
How did you find out I was in trouble?
Bad news always travel fast.
We ran into a couple of your ranch hands. Grant's men had run them off.
He's been doing that for months now, trying to force me into selling out by making it impossible for me to work my ranch. He thinks that just because I'm a woman, he can bully me into doing anything he wants. He's very much mistaken.
Why does Grant want your property?
To build a stagecoach road across it. I offered him a right-of-way, but he insists on all or nothing.
That not make sense.
You're right, Tonto. Grant must want this ranch for something a lot more important than a stagecoach road, or he'd be willing to compromise. How many hands are working for you now, Miss Carter?
Just Bill Morgan, my foreman. He stuck with me through all my trouble.
Why not me work here, Kemosabe?
No, Tonto. I think it's more important that you try to get a job at Grant's ranch. That way, we'll have some idea what he plans to do.
Me try get job somehow.
Tonto, I'll contact you as soon as I've rounded up a couple of ranch hands to work for Miss Carter.
Me be waiting.
I'm afraid that's impossible. Why, every man in the county knows what Grant's roughnecks would do to him if he worked for me.
Not every man. I'll send you two who won't be afraid of Grant or anybody else. Have you ever heard of Pete Lacey and Pedro Martinez?
Are you ready?
Si.
Go.
Caramba! You missed me by 2 whole inches.
You couldn't hit me if I had donkey's ears.
Well, try again. This time I'll make it really tough.
You think that's shooting? Watch this.
Madre mia, I don't like this. Have you ever missed a cigarette and hit a man?
Only the last 2 times. Fellow wasn't hurt much.
Oh, Silver. There's the 2 men I'm looking for. Come on, Silver. Put up those guns, men. Only fools risk their lives without reason.
Dad, Bernie and I just had it lined up perfect. Who do you think you're talking to, masked man?
To a couple of men who once helped me capture some outlaws in Cactus County. Have you forgotten?
Caramba, now I'm knowing you. This masked man is our friend, the Lone Ranger.
Don't you two ever get tired of fighting each other?
Oh, nothing, senor. We just have the little duel to pass the time of day.
Don't you have anything better to do? You're two of the best bronc riders in the territory. Tell me, why aren't you working?
Work? No, thanks, friend. Work don't agree with us.
That's right, amigo. We're two of the laziest hombres in the whole county.
Well, that's too bad. The Carter Ranch could use a couple of husky men like you.
Why us? There's plenty of good hands in these parts.
Not anymore. Jeff Grant and his roughnecks have run them off. He's trying to force Miss Ellen Carter into selling out to him.
Miss Ellen? Why didn't you say so before? This senorita, is she pretty?
You'll have to decide that for yourself.
We do it. Pedro Martinez have never failed to help the beautiful senorita in distress.
You go on ahead to her ranch. I'll meet you there later.
I ride like the wind.
You'll have to ride faster than that if you want to beat me, you beautiful girl. Really going through with this thing, are we?
Work? Pedro Martinez de Salvador y Runiega have given his promise.
Well, but supposing she's one of them strong-minded, hatchet-faced females?
Well, in that case, Pedro Martinez de Salvador y Runiega will break his promise.
We'd like a job.
Si, senorita, we would like a job.
Oh, you must be the two men the Lone Ranger told me about.
Si, senorita. My friend Pete Lacey, he's the world's best pistol shot. And I, Pedro Martinez de Salvado y Runiega, can throw the whip better than I can throw the ball.
Bill, would you come here a minute, please? Bill, here are two men who actually want to work for me. This is Bill Morgan, my foreman.
How are you? I sure hope you two fellas don't scare easily. If Jeff Grant hears you're working for us, he'll send some of his gang over here to rough you up.
Pedro Martinez is afraid of nobody. And my friend, Pete Lacey, he's afraid of nobody but Pedro.
That's a lie, you lazy, honorary polecat. I can outduel you any day.
Take it easy, boys. You're both hired, lazy or not. Drop your blanket rolls in the bunkhouse, and I'll be with you in 5 minutes.
Si, senor. It will be a great pleasure to work for the beautiful senorita.
Likewise.
Ay, that Michelle. Could you not see the love light in her eyes for Pedro Martinez?
That was me she was looking at, you spit-pearl baboon.
If this Jeff Grant tries to hurt her, first I cut his throat, then I shoot his heart out, and then I kill him. Caramba, senor. You're even better than I am, and that is impossible.
This may come in handy, boys. Tonto is working as cook's helper at Grant's ranch. He warned me we can expect a visit from Grant's men at any time now.
Good. I've been kind of watching for him to come.
You've been watching the beautiful Michelle. And all the time is for me, she sighs.
Wait a minute. Riders are coming.
Yeah, they're Grant's men, all right.
Good. We gave them a welcome they do not expect.
You're trespassing on private property. What do you want?
That Carter female must be so hard up for help, she had to hire a masked man to work for her. We want you to vamoose, that's what we want.
Vamoose? Mister, we like it here.
It ain't healthy to like it here. Now, do you want to go peaceful, or shall we show you just how unhealthy it is?
Pedro Martinez have never felt in better health.
You're the ones who are going to vamoose.
That masked hombre talks big. Let's get him, boys.
Hey, one down and three to go.
That should hold you for a while.
That'll show them who's going to vamoose.
You can go now. Tell Grant if he sends any more of his men, they'll get the same treatment.
Si, and tell them if they bother Miss Ellen again, we're going to really get mad and hurt somebody.
Now get.
Corren, canalla!
I'm going to try to see Tonto. When Grant finds out his bullying tactics won't work anymore, he's likely to try something a lot more drastic. I'll see you later.
So the four of you, Hefty, weren't even a match for two lazy drifters and some hombre wearing a mask.
I told you, Mr. Grant, they used whips and guns.
You had guns too, didn't you? I've had enough fooling around. I want that property before Ellen Carter finds out there's gold on it.
She's a stubborn female, boss.
Why don't you give up and start digging the vein you found on your own property?
When the biggest part of it extends across into the Carter Ranch? No, thanks. If you won't be sensible, I'll just have to get a ranch another way. A sure way. Get out of here, engine. You're supposed to be helping the cook. Can't you see we're talking business?
What do you mean, a sure way, boss? She said she'd never sell to you as long as she lives.
Then we'll just have to fix it so she doesn't live long.
What did you find out, Tonto?
Plenty, Kemosabe. Gold on Carter Ranch.
So that's why Grant wants it.
Them plan something heap bad. Send me out of room so me can't hear.
Come on. There's a window open over there.
I tell you, boss, I don't like it. Killing a woman.
I don't care what you like or don't like. It's the only way. Besides, it won't be murder. It'll be an accident. An unfortunate accident. Once she's out of the way, I'll be able to buy the place for a song. There's not another ranch in the county with nerve enough to bid against me.
But what if somebody gets suspicious? Accidents like that don't happen all by themselves.
If anybody gets blamed, it'll be those two worthless drifters, Pete and Pedro. They won't be able to defend themselves because they'll be
dead, too.
Hold it.
Reach. No tricks. What's the matter?
Looks like this engine was cooking up more than food, boss.
This the hombre from the Carter Ranch?
Yeah. He and the engine sure heard an earful.
That's one earful they're going to wish they hadn't heard. Take him down to the barn.
What are you going to do with him, boss? If they spill what they just heard?
Don't worry. They won't get a chance. We'll take them with us to the Carter place. Nice thing about a fire. It burns up all the evidence, including dead bodies.
The Lone Ranger and Tonto, in their efforts to help Ellen Carter save her ranch, have been captured by ruthless Jeff Grant and his men.
Make it good and tight. I'd hate to lose such nice kindling wood.
We found their horses, boss. The big silver one was in that clump of trees.
Good. Let's get going.
You're a fool, Grant, if you think you can get away with this.
You're the fool, masked man. I don't make plans that won't work.
Get them on their horses.
You forget we're not the only ones trying to help Ellen Carter. She has other friends, too.
Who? Bill Morgan? It'll be one against five.
Aren't you forgetting those two new hands she hired? Pete and Pedro?
Those two show-offs? Yeah, I know all about them, and they don't worry me a bit. We'll take care of Pete and Pedro just like we're going to take care of you. Come on.
The beautiful Senorita Ellen. When she sees this, no longer can she resist Pedro Martinez.
Pedro Martinez, that big windbag.
I reckon this will show Miss Ellen who's the man for her.
I'll put it over her head like this. Then I'll crush her in my arms like this.
Let's just see how it looks.
Hey, that even looks good on me. What chance have Pete Lacey against me?
You tell a big lie.
And you said you'd be tending the stock. That's a bigger lie.
What a beautiful senorita, eh? The minute my back is turned, you're making love behind my front, eh?
I suppose you're going to wear that over your head.
What's the matter with you, boy? Don't you two ever stop squabbling. Say, those are right pretty looking doodads. What you going to do with them?
Didn't you ever see a wedding present before?
Gee, we've decided it's time for Miss Ellen to get married.
Say, that's a fine idea. Well, good luck, boys.
You see, just like I'm telling you, she's eating her heart out for Pedro Martinez.
If she's in love with anybody, it's me.
We let her make the choose.
Reach. Stick him in the old storehouse with the masked hombre in the engine. Looks like just the right place for our little accident to happen. Come on, boys.
Oh, Pete and Pedro. I'm sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be your trouble?
We got kind of a problem, ma'am.
Si, senorita. We are both in love.
Well, I think that's wonderful. Who are the lucky girls?
But that is the problem, senorita. The lucky girl, she's only one. And I am for she.
Dad read it. You said you'd let her choose.
Oh, well, that's very flattering, boys, but you see...
Don't anybody move.
Just what is this, Mr. Grant?
It's a funeral, Miss Carter. Your funeral.
Caramba! At a time like this, my back is where my front should be.
If this is another one of your attempts to frighten me into selling out, it won't work. And if you harm any of my friends, I'll have the law on you.
That'll be kind of hard to do, Miss Carter, if you and your friends are all dead.
I'm sure glad you never bothered to tear down this old storehouse, Miss Carter. Makes a dandy coffin. Strong enough to hold you in and dry enough to burn like tinder. Okay, men, get the fire ready. You should have sold when I asked you to, Miss Carter. Now it's too late.
You're going to have a hard time explaining this fire to the sheriff, Grant.
I don't think so. How can you prove who started a fire if all the witnesses are dead? All ready, boss.
Okay, let it go.
Well, keep cool. Good work, boys. Won't be long now. Come on, we don't want to be seen here. We'll hide out at the ranch house till it's over. And if anybody comes along and tries to put out that fire, we'll take care of them, too.
Take it easy, Ellen.
Don't worry, Miss Ellen. We get you out somehow.
Mister, you didn't give us got a ring here. Turn our backs on them polecats of Grant's.
And no use, Kimasabi. Knot's too tight. Need knife.
Right. Got to do something. The window.
Broken glass, good night. But window too high.
Yes, unfortunately. Tonto, hop over to the door. We may be able to force it open. Hurry, Tonto.
Handle break. Look, Kimasabi. Where? Break window.
The glass. There isn't a second to lose.
Caramba, senor. What are you doing?
Pull out your wrist, Tonto. Glad I'm wearing gloves. Glass is hot.
Hey, it might work. We can just get out. I know where they throw the guns, in the bunkhouse.
Look!
Hey, senor, make with a hurry. Pronto, eh?
Press tighter, Tonto.
Time for us to call the boss. Take a look.
Yeah, nothing but smoke. By now, they'll be burnt to a crisp.
Let's go here.
Get their guns, Tonto. It's all right, Miss Carter.
Like a boy band and song on the rooftop. When the rubble's dead, we'll go clap. When the rope slips, they'll land on their feet. And time will come by. There's no one people.
Miss Carter? Carter, we've got them tied up in the barn. Pete and Pedro are going for the sheriff. You won't have any more trouble with Grant or his men.
Oh, that's fine. And I can hardly believe what you told me about the gold. Now Bill and I will really be able to make a success of the ranch.
Don't you think we ought to get married first?
Married? You mean all the time she have been in love with he?
I'm afraid so, Pedro. But we want you both to be best man at our wedding.
There's only one best man, and that is Pedro Martinez de Solvado y Runiega.
Concern it, that's a lie. Pete Lace is a better man than Pedro Martinez ever was.
You men made insult. Come, we fight a duel. And after we kill each other, we go for the sheriff.
They're a great pair, Miss Carter. Come on, Tonto. We have more work to do. Adios.
Goodbye.
Bye. There goes an even greater pair. Just think, Bill, we might have lost everything if it weren't for the Lone Ranger.
With the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty high-o silver, the Lone Ranger.
This is a story of one of the most mysterious characters to appear in the early days of the West. He was a fabulous individual, a man whose presence brought fear to the lawless and hope to those who wanted to make this frontier land their home. He was known as the Lone Ranger. Indians on the warpath. Red man versus white. Burnings, scalpings, atrocities, massacres. These scenes of bloodshed and death finally have vanished from the West at the time our story opens. For the great white father in Washington has acted in the Indians' behalf. The pipe of peace has been smoked and solemn treaties made which guarantee forever the rights and property of the red man. He has been given large grants of land on which to live. Regular shipments of supplies to provide for his needs are sent him on rigid schedules from the East. And law and order in his territory is being maintained by the presence of United States troops. For a long period, the Indians live contentedly and in harmony with the white man. Then one day, a smoke signal appears in the sky, a signal which for many centuries has been the Indian's telegraph, his means of transmitting a message across the miles. On this particular day, the message from afar was of importance to Tonto, friend and faithful companion of the Lone Ranger.
Two quick puffs. That's your sign, Tonto.
Come from Cheyenne country.
Must be from Chief Swift Eagle.
Chief Swift Eagle, good friend. See what him want.
Also, he's a canyon. Look so.
He says that it's important to see you right away, but he doesn't say why.
Ah, Chief Swift Eagle have plenty good reason or him not send for Tonto. Me signal me go.
Also, he say gagnon, look so.
We find him on Washita Reservation.
Then you'd better be on your way.
You not come, Kimasabi?
No, Tonto, I want to visit Father Batista at his mission. He may have some news for me.
When me see you again?
I'll meet you at the big cave on the Washita River in 2 days. You go on. I'll break up camp.
Me hurry, see what friends want.
Tonto.
Yes, Kemosabe?
They're strict around the reservations these days. Be sure to report to the Indian agent in charge there.
Me see him first thing.
Welcome, my son. It's been a long time since you last passed this way.
Yes, it has. Thank you.
Where's Tonto?
He went to see his friend, Chief Swift Eagle, on the Washita Reservation.
The Washita?
Why, yes. Something wrong, Father?
I hope he doesn't meet with trouble.
Trouble? What kind of trouble?
The Army has issued orders that any Indians found off their reservations south of the Cimarron River are to be arrested as renegades.
Renegades?
Yes. And they're to be exiled to the Florida Everglades.
Why, those disease-infested swamps would kill a northern Indian in less than a week.
I know.
Why, Father? What's the reason behind it all?
Oh, Inspector. Here's someone who can tell you about it.
Good morning, Father.
This is Inspector Williams from the Department of Indian Affairs. Don't let the mask cause you any concern, Inspector. This is the Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger. Say, I've heard a lot about you.
Glad to meet you, Inspector. Father Batista has told me about the order exiling Indians from their homes.
Oh? Well, that order was issued to protect the food and supplies we send to the Indians.
What do you mean?
Our supply trains haven't been getting through.
They've been attacked?
That's right. Renegade Indians. They slaughter the drivers and take the supplies.
You're positive it's done by Indians?
That's the report from one of our own agents, Jim Lackey.
Yes, he should know. But to call any Indian found off the reservation a renegade.
Oh, well, that was the Army's idea, not ours.
I see.
Now you see why I was concerned about Tonto.
I'll see to it that nothing happens to Tonto. I'll start for the Washita right away.
Do you mind if I ride along with you? I'm on a tour of inspection. That's where I'm going.
Glad to have you, Inspector. Bye, Father.
Adios, Father. And many thanks for your hospitality.
You were most welcome.
Thank you.
Good luck, my friends.
Adios. On, Silver.
Where have you been, Bolin? I've been sitting on fish hooks all day waiting for you.
What's eating you, Lackey?
Did you and your cutthroats raid that supply train that's coming in?
No. Didn't know there was one.
That's a relief.
Something wrong, Lackey?
You bet there is. We've got to lay off for a while. The Indian Bureau is bellering its head off.
You think they're getting wise?
No. They still think it's renegade Indians.
Well, then, what do we got to worry about?
This letter from Washington. Just one more raid, and there's going to be a special investigation.
That wouldn't be so good. If anyone came snooping around here, they might find out that me and my boys are deserters.
What do you mean, might? Now, we've got to take it easy and let some of those supplies get through. At least until things cool off a little.
Hold it.
How?
What's your business, Indian?
Me come to Washita, see Chief Swift Eagle.
What do you want with Swift Eagle?
Him old friend, make powwow.
You got your own rations?
Me got food.
It's a good thing. Grub is too scarce around here these days to be feeding stray Indians.
You have plenty food soon. Pass supply train on way here.
Glad to hear it. That'll be good news for Swift Eagle and his outfit. What do you call yourself?
Me Tonto, not Cheyenne. Come from north.
All right, you can go now. You'll find Swift Eagle camp 4 miles up the line.
Wait a minute, Injun. What did you say your name was?
Me Tonto.
That's all. Something mighty familiar about that engine.
Ah, all Indians look alike.
Maybe. But I've seen him before. See you later.
For many moons now, my people hungry. Many of them weak and sick. Must have food, white man's medicine to make them well again. That why me send for you, Tonto, in hope you and your good friend, the Lone Ranger, will help.
Kemosabe helps Swift Eagle's people. Him good friend.
But you say you not see him till tomorrow.
That right?
Maybe too late then. Supply train now, one day's ride away. We'll be in Blue Canyon by next sunrise. That where every attack made.
That not good.
Swift Eagle ask Indian agent Lackey protect supplies, but they no get here. Now time come for Swift Eagle to act. Escort supply train with best warriors.
That bad, Swift Eagle. Indian agent make big trouble if you go off reservation.
Him not know what we do till wagon arrive safe.
Maybe men with wagons think you renegades start battle.
Swift Eagle think of that. But also think of my people who starve and die. We watch wagon from hills. Show ourselves only if attack made. You come, Tonto?
Tonto ride with good friend Swift Eagle.
Oh, he come.
There's the spot I was to meet Tonto. But it seems that someone else got there first. Looks like an army patrol.
Yes. Could be a detachment from Fort Mason looking for renegades. Hope they don't take your friend Tonto for a renegade, if they meet up with him.
Tonto will be careful. I wasn't to meet him until tomorrow. Meanwhile, Inspector, we'll camp up the line. The soldiers may be gone by morning. Then I'll come back and meet Tonto. On, Silver.
Figured out who he is. I saw him in Fort Dodge about a year ago.
Well?
He's the engine that rides with the Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger? Are you sure?
Positive.
We can't have him snooping around here. He might bring in his masked friend.
Yeah.
That masked man might be here even now.
Well, what do we do?
We're gonna have a talk with that Indian.
That night, Bolin and Lackey, after failing to find Tonto or Chief Swift Eagle, cruelly forced the chief's terrified squaw to give them the information they demand.
I think this is about the best break we ever got.
What do you mean, break?
The brass in Washington think the Indians have been staging these raids, don't they? Now we prove it.
How? You heard her say they rode off to guard the supply train, not attack it.
My orders say that all Indians found off the reservation are renegades. Well, Swift Eagle and all his braves are off the reservation right now.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Now, Swift Eagle still thinks that your men are army regulars. It'll be a cinch to arrest them.
Yeah. And you follow the War Department's order and send them to the Everglades.
But they'll never reach Florida. Your men will shoot them when they try to escape. All nice and legal.
I get it. Then Washington has nothing to investigate.
Right. We better round up the boys at the cave. They got work to do.
What about her?
She can't do anything. Come on.
The next morning, the Lone Ranger, after leaving Inspector Williams to ride on to the Washita Reservation alone, returns to the cave, where he has arranged to meet his faithful Indian companion, Tonto. The cave is deserted of soldiers, yet the masked man sees no sign of his Indian friend.
Easy, big fellow. Easy.
Thank you.
guys doing here?
What's it to you?
They're the ones the Indians never received. I'll get over there.
Hey, what are you going to do?
Keep you quiet and out of the way for a while. Move. There, that should hold you. I have to find Inspector Williams. Monsieur!
Get those engines off their horses, Pete. Well, hurry up.
Well, how'd it go?
They surrendered without firing a shot.
You thought the army had turned on them, huh? What did you do with them?
I had my men take them to the cave. They'll be safe there until we get rid of them.
What'd you bring Swift Eagle here for?
You've forgotten about the Lone Ranger? One of my men heard the chief talk about him. I figured between the two of them, we'd find out where the masked man is.
Here they are, boss.
They make big mistake. We not ride to attack supply train.
That's right, Mr. Lackey. We guard train, so food will come.
Guard it? You mean attack it?
You know the army order. Indians found off their reservation are to be considered renegades and deported to the Florida Everglades.
Well, Injun, you think your pal, the Lone Ranger, can help you now?
Kemosabe, good man. Him find out truth.
Where's the Lone Ranger now?
Why you want to know?
That's our business. Well, speak up. Oh, another stubborn Injun. Maybe this will loosen your tongue. You gonna talk now? You keep out of this.
You think you can beat it out of him?
If I can't, I'll go to work on Swift Eagle.
Hold it, Bolin. There's someone coming up the road. Now, we'll find out what he wants, but you and Pete keep your guns handy in case we have to get out of here quick.
What about them?
Oh, we're just attending to official business. Questioning a couple of captured renegades. Hello. Where's...
What are you doing to these Indians? Where's the agent in charge?
That's me.
Inspector Williams, Bureau of Indian Affairs. Now, what's the meaning of this?
Well, we caught these Indians stalking a wagon train.
These men wrong, Inspector. Cheyenne, honest Indians.
Shut up. This is an army matter, mister.
On the contrary, it's a matter for the Bureau, no? And you're not using that whip anymore. I demand a full explanation.
Well, now, just a minute, Inspector. It's like this, you see.
It'll keep him quiet for a while.
What did you do that for? Now we'll have to get out of here fast. We'll take what we've made and call it quits.
You're not getting afraid, are you? We can take care of the inspector and the engines.
Well, I still don't like it. Not with a Lone Ranger around. I'm getting out. Well, anyway, it sure paid off while it lasted. Too bad we had to cut it short like this.
You know, Lackey, I just been thinking. Washington don't know nothing about me and Pete here. With the two engines, the inspector and you out of the way?
You wouldn't.
Why not? What do you say to a two-way split, Pete?
Sounds good, boss.
There's your answer, Lackey.
Sniveling coward, either.
Say, what about the men at the cave?
Why worry about them? After all, who can trust army deserters with money? Get outside and get the horses. I got a little unfinished business in here.
Right, boss.
Taking care of you two engines is going to give me extra special pleasure.
Hurry up in there!
Be right with you, Pete. Now, Tonto, start saying your prayers to your totem.
Bowen for a long time. Come along.
Sergeant, take charge of these deserters. Now, stranger, who are you?
A man who just saved our lives.
Inspector Williams.
Hello, Flynn. You got here just in time.
This is Lieutenant Murray.
Inspector? Lieutenant?
His company from Fort Mason was out looking for deserters when they met our supplies ran.
We heard some shots as we were bringing Flynn's wagon up the trail. Sounded like trouble, so we came on ahead.
Bowen, one of the men you're looking for?
He certainly is. We've been looking for him and his friends for over a year.
Hear him say rest of men in cave near Washita. They renegades. They raid supply train, not Indians.
That's right. I found some of the supplies stolen from the wagon train still in the cave.
Bowen kill Indian agent. Him body inside.
What?
Him speak truth, Lieutenant. Indian agent plan raids. But Bowen shoot him when they go to split up money.
I'm beginning to understand a few things now, Lieutenant. Our agent, Lackey, wanted us to believe that renegade Indians were raiding the supply trains, while he and Bowen and his men were the real renegades.
Say, you got here just in time.
I was on my way to find you, Inspector. I heard some gunshots. I knew something was wrong.
Kimasabe, many Swift Eagles braves held prisoner in cave now. Bowen have his men take them to cave after they capture us.
So, some more of Bowen's deserted friends are around here. Well, my troop will take care of them in a hurry.
Then you won't need us anymore, Lieutenant.
We're certainly indebted to you and your Indian friend here.
Chief Swift Eagle, you can tell your people from now on that their supplies will be sure of getting through.
You have my word on that, Swift Eagle.
Swift Eagle and his people never forget this day. Are their friend Tonto or Tonto's good friend?
Montano.
Who'd you say that masked man was?
Well, he's the Lone Ranger.
Well, what do you know? The Lone Ranger.